the power of the idea. You know, a lot of people think that it takes money to be successful, but it doesn't. If you have a look at firing every one of you tomorrow, simply by shopping somewhere else. And you have to be important, but we're not important compared to the importance of the customer. Now, when you go to the office, how many of you spend at least 65% of your time focusing on the customer? How many? Not many. We worry about our products, we worry about the way our operation runs, we worry about the accounts, we worry about all that sort of stuff, but none of that is important. Because without the customer, or without the customer buying things, without the customer loving you, you don't have a business, doesn't matter how good you are. Inside my business, there's a dozen skill sets that I really need to know. I'm a CEO, therefore, I need to be a good administrator, I need to know about accounting, I need to know about sales, I need to know about leadership, I need to know about teamwork, I need to know about communication, I need to be good at all those things, and probably a bunch more. How many of you have actually sat down and looked at all the skill sets that you need to be successful? Most of us don't. How many of us can honestly say, anybody that thinks that they are at least 8 out of 10 in all the skill sets that they need to do their job properly or do the job that they want to do in the future properly? That's not anybody who thinks they're 8 out of 10 in all of those things. How many of you got up this morning and the very first thing you did was look up your competitor's website? Nah, why not? Serious question. If you think about it, there are two ways to build your business, isn't there? The first one is to grow the market, so you get the same size of a bigger pie. That's one way. That's hard, isn't it? The second way is to take business off your competitor, right? So if you're going to take business off your competitor, you have to know how to work with your internal customers as it is to work with your external customers. Mall of America. It's a shopping mall. 66,000 bus trips to Mall of America. 2.5 times the attendance of Disney World. It's a series of shops. Why do people go there? Because it's an experience. People love to shop. Those of you who are in retail or those of you who sell products in retail, people love to shop. The reason they're going to the internet, buying off the internet, is because you're not giving them an experience. Hands up everybody who thinks having a good product is important. Come on! All of you. So we've got nearly 100% to all of us. You know, 87% of all advertising today is based around the product, price, satisfied customers, or brand awareness. 87%. And he gets out, you know, and it's the middle of the night, and he's got his dark sunglasses on, walking around. And he says, what do you think you're doing? And I said, I just say, it's why. And I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but at the moment I'm going to put it in the car so it doesn't get run. So the cop says, 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, that penguin has to be in the zoo. Okay, no problem. So a week later, I'm walking down the street in Santa Monica, and I've now bought this penguin, this lovely little diamond thing, and I'm walking down the street with this penguin. And the same cop comes over and he says, I thought I told you last week to take that penguin to the zoo. I said, I did. Today we go to the movies. Because we are the knowledge business. The person with the most knowledge wins. And I just put aside 4 hours a week. That's all I put aside. And it's made such a tremendous difference to my life. We know what we want. We know how to sell products. It's all about getting sales. It's about selling people stuff. Morrison Collins showed that customer service leaders, the company in each category, across 28 categories, that provided the best customer service, could charge 9 to 13% more than their competitors without losing the sale. Now you have a think about 13%. Let's say you're selling a product at $2. Let's say you're selling a product at $2 and it costs you $1.80 to make, you wouldn't, but let's just suggest you do. And you can add 13% onto that without losing the business. All of a sudden you can charge $2.26 to get your business. You're taking your profit from 26 to 46 cents. So just giving people great customer service can make a huge difference to your profit margin. Companies that the customer service leaders grow at double the speed of their competitors because they've got word of mouth. The latest Harper's Bazaar study, just a couple of months ago, showed that every time you gave somebody fantastic knock your socks off service, 633 people were actually told about it. You told people, they told people. 633 people heard about the fantastic service you gave. You phoned the number, the voice on the other end said, Santa Monica Liquor Store. When somebody buys your product in good faith, irrespective of whether it's a Volvo truck or whether it's my tapes or whatever, satisfy people's needs, they always should get their money back. And it doesn't matter what the product or service is, you should always stand behind your product and give people their money back.
Because that's a good investment.
It's just morally the right thing to do. The people that actually complain are usually just the tip of the iceberg. For every one person that complains about any service or quality, there's another 100 that don't complain. So if you don't address the issue, then sooner or later it's going to come and bite you.
I understand the balance thing because I travel all the time and I travel all the time. But I have unique, different sort of job than most people who, you know, live in the same town that they work in. I just don't have to do it. And I'm the first to agree that my balance is not very good. But I have up with him that I take my son often when he's not at school. And so he's 11 and he's been to China and he's been to Japan and he's been to Hong Kong and he's been to Australia and he's been to South Africa and he's been to England and he's been to France. And he's seen an awful lot of the world, and that's been fantastic for his education, and that's all gone in time.
And what you have seen, though, is that you have to work harder, you have to be much more focused on what you're doing, you have to set things differently, and
I don't think you have to work hard.
No?
I think most of us work hard. Most of us work too hard. It's about working smarter, it's not about working hard. Once they started setting goals and knowing exactly where they were going, that they found they had so much more time because they were just that much more organised. And so instead of being able to do less, they actually could do a lot more in a lot less time. And I think that's true. I think the more disciplined you are as far as goals, setting out a to-do sheet every day, dealing with the things that are important and not just the things that come up, You can actually cut down the amount of work to do and still be much more effective. How many of us walk past the receptionist and don't think they're important? That just somebody answers the phone and they leave and get somebody else. And yet they're your front line with your customer. Often, they're your front line with the customer. They usually turn up at 9 o'clock, go home at 5, they have no idea why they're there. They don't really know what you're up to. They're not involved in any processes. And we found that by involving everybody, we've done this with a number of businesses, involve everybody. Get everybody. You know, it's amazing what suggestions come from people that have nothing to do with what you're working on. They'll come up with a suggestion and you think, wow, that's fantastic. Why did I think of that? You don't involve them, you don't get those answers. And once somebody believes in your company, if you start explaining to your receptionist what you're doing, why you're doing it, why, and get them involved in meetings and things, you get this huge lift in enthusiasm and participation, and everybody just works so much better, and the company's more efficient, the customers can hear that additional enthusiasm. So I'd involve everybody, and I'd look at everything you do and say, is this the best way to do it? I'd start measuring all the results. I mean, what's the point of advertising if you can't measure the results? What's the point of doing anything if you can't measure the results? Everything's measurable and sure. Because it's tough out there. And it's a tough world. At the start of my speech, I said, who's finding it tough? And everybody said yes. It's going to get a lot tougher. Right? It's tough, but it's going to get harder. And it's going to get more competitive. And so if you're not prepared for it now, you're going to be less prepared in 2 or 3 years' time.